welcome back to my channel. To be exact, Brianna did film this all on her camera, not on mine, because I got mine taken away for a while. And yeah, today's video is going to be Brianna taking over my whole entire vlog during science for like an hour or two. But yeah, so I hope you guys enjoy this video. Like and subscribe, and yeah.
I am not having a good morning, and I just, hey, I got two emails about the same thing, and then I said something, and then now this other email says something, and I don't understand.
Thinking full and color my emotion.
I don't know about this date. I do not
understand. She might be on slow-mo. I'm confused.
I don't know. I
might look like stupid right now.
You
ready?
But
I'm not on slow-mo.
No, I'm, ow!
If
you
are on slow-mo,
they got
me hitting you with the headphone.
You have to be nice.
Oh,
this is
like,
ew, my hair.
I'm
doing really
bad.
Do you need to take
your
shirt?
All right. So to fix that problem.
No.
Oh,
okay.
Well,
you should put it in slow-mo.
These things happen only at plate boundaries. The middles and ridges are when the ocean floor separates and magma comes out of the crack there. And then the other one that only happens in the trenches because of the ocean floor sinking.
Oh, we can leave that. Okay.
An ocean plate sinking under a different ocean plate. So you get trenches that way. Okay. The other thing can happen anywhere. Like, you can still get earthquakes even if it's not on the plate boundary. But like, you know how like California's on a plate boundary that's transformed? You can still get earthquakes like over on the east side of California, even though it's really far from that boundary, because other faults and cracks in the rock can still move. And if they move and release pressure, then they'll release energy. And volcanoes. Volcanoes are often associated with two plates subducting. One melting, like a before spreading one. But you can also get volcanoes of the island chain variety, where the mantle makes a plume of energy, like this really hot magma. And any part of the crust that's sitting over that mantle plume, could the magma could push up through the seafloor and start building a volcanic island. And if it breaches the surface of the water, then it keeps on making magma solidifying and becomes a volcanic island. And then after a while, that island will be there, and then the crust will move on, but the mantle plume will still be spewing out extra magma. So then you can get another little island forming. And that's why Hawaii has like a chain of, is it 8 islands? I actually looked this up last year, but I can't remember some facts. So Hawaiian has a chain because each of them sat over the same mantle plume, and then the plate moved along, and then you could still drive to other parts of the island that are like windy roads and rustic and rainforesty. Yeah, it's pretty cool. And you can go ziplining there. And
hide my baby.
What else can you do now?
I cannot.
Oh, you can go
you can eat.
Parasailing and take surf lessons.
Oh, you could take paddleboarding lessons.
And what else can
you? Portaback. No. Oh, what is it called?
Bellyboard?
Paddleboard.
Paddleboard. Yeah, paddleboard. Ooh, that's fun. Yes.
I know how to paddleboard.
So do I. Yeah, Hawaii is our island.
Dare I ask?
We took over Hawaii Islands, and then they were adopted as our last state.
They come in my conversation, so.
Don't ask me when, but it was the last state.
And they're also bringing me back, so.
And so if you want to do tropical travel, and you don't want to risk speaking foreign languages and having weird money, then you should go to Hawaii, because it's American owned and everything is normal. The food, the money.
Yeah,
the
I have one. I just saw one on the deck.
Yeah, if you go to the French West Indies, they all speak French to you, and then they think you're bad because you're American. Right? But they do speak also English.
What time is this?
But they're not American country, and their money is.
What time does the bell ring?
You know?
No one's ready to schedule.
Not yet, but they said it probably will be.
We still have to
do okay, so anyways, so
regular schedule.
So we're gonna see why plates cause earthquakes and volcanoes.
Oh wait, no.
Later, but today we're just seeing how the sea floor
is. We still have to do
our
tests. So
like how we get new rock on the sea floor. Where's
really
my little other page?
But what time is it?
Oh yeah, so. Some of you didn't finish this.
10:30. Oh,
not
shit.
Many of you.
10:30.
But these words were all up here.
A.M.
So wait, the number one is plate tectonic theory, and then number two is they're called giant slabs called plates. Number three, the two plates meet is called a plate boundary. Number four, they don't hit. They go like that.
Yeah, it's not
then that's a fault boundary. Any crack in a rock is also called a fault because moving relative to each other like that, it makes a line, and the line is called a fault.
Stop.
So the area of movement is also called a fault. That's why it's called the San Andreas Fault. Did you hear that? So the edge of the Pacific Plate and the North American Plate is called the San Andreas Fault. And it's also a huge area of movement that causes earthquake energy. And finally, did you see the word earthquake? No, because they hyphenated.
Hallelujah.
So, if they
hallelujah.
If the energy gets released at a fault boundary, you get an earthquake.
Hallelujah.
And finally, the last two are volcanoes and mountains.
She's no fun.
I know I'm not. I'm
not mountains and volcanoes come from this kind of boundary. Hello.
Sure.
On the test, I wrote converging means come together. I put it on the test. And then somebody said, I don't know what that word means. And I'm like, freaking read, people.
Can you help me
on, you know
can
I mean?
Help me on the test?
Because I get it.
No,
like,
it's a quiz.
If
it's
so,
a quiz
converging,
or a test.
If it comes like this, it's converging.
If I don't know, answer
and
can
if
help me.
They're both continent, they'll,
yeah,
they'll make mountains.
It's a quiz.
Because they'll just crust, push all that crust upward.
And
they'll fold it and smoosh it.
I did.
Look, you're not looking, you're still not looking. Another kind of converging is when the ocean floor hits the continent and it subducts.
Subducts
is a fancy way of saying sink.
It's like kind of confusing.
And if it sinks, what does it become? What's this stuff?
But I've been getting E grade, so.
Something about what? Who?
I might do good. Probably will.
Yeah, magma. It becomes magma.
Anyway.
Everybody get it? Okay. And then you have a cute little paragraph part for you to explain the
wrong way.
What the C4 spreading is. Hello, what happens to C4 spreading?
Oh, I knew she was playing the song.
The plates spread apart? Yes.
Okay.
But I don't know if I whited it out on every test because it's, some of these are still saying minus two. So you have two areas where it is doing subduction and making trenches. And you have one area where it is the mid-ocean ridge making the new rock. Thanks for raising your hand. Next. What? Everybody get it? Your class is so nice. You're so nice. Okay, so what did I say? This is the test. And then when you're done, I got rid of the name blank. Because I want you to write your name on the side that has the test. For kindly cooperating, the only thing you can have on your table is a pencil and this groovy blue model paper. At
okay.
the end of
oh,
the
oh, we
test,
can use that?
I am collecting
oh, yes.
your groovy
okay,
new model paper.
Okay,
so make
so,
sure your groovy name is on the top of the model.
Phones, well,
otherwise, how will you get any credit for it?
But I'm going to vlog.
You know what I'm saying?
Why not?
It's just a homework
so,
credit.
I will be back.
You don't
have
to.
This. Oh, I
think
it's
on so my we will turn in the model at the end of everybody's test and we'll throw them in the basket and pass the basket. But the test paper will be collected.
Oh,
thank
okay.
you for raising your hand. And Delica, what?
Can I please move my seat for the test?
Yeah, you can sit on the side there, the side there, the side there.
Okay.
Or
what?
Way on the other.
I know. She
okay.
Understand.
Are you done moving around then?
Okay.
Got them.
Those are not fake.
They're fake.
They're not fake. I don't have fake stuff.
Okay.
You might have, but I don't. Huh? I know, because my brother took them.
And remember the husband rule, Ben? Okay, right. Remember the husband rule?
What?
The husband rule.
Oh, yeah.
When you wear your hood on your head, you are a hoodlum. Because you're breaking your defiance and breaking Miss Nunez's rule of don't wear hoods in class. I don't know. Usually if I say it once, it works. But there's that one kid in period two that always puts it right back on because he can't figure out that there's a hood on his head again. So I gave him a referral. And then there was this really cool kid in period four. And I was standing there teaching the whole time. And when I finally said, take off your hood, guess what he was wearing in his ears?
Headphones.
Yeah. Word I was saying, I'm a big. And then,
so Angelica left because she doesn't want to help me.
To inform me that they were borrowed.
Hold on, so I'm gonna have my stuff right here. I'm gonna be blocking one.
And then, the nice kid that lent them to him, because he's so cute, you know, he would never get caught with
them,
right?
You could have asked,
she watched me take them away from him. And she did not say, by the way, those are mine. So then I gave them to Miss Nunez and I made her write a paper saying I gave them to her, right? Because for some reason I was thinking like these would be worth more than a phone, but they're really not, but they're so small, right? And then she went and signed my paper, but she signed my hand. So then at lunch I went to Miss Judy and I said, here's the paper. Miss Nunez has those AirPod things, right? With the case and everything. And then it gets better. So then Ms. Nunez had them, and Gammy's parents are supposed to pick them up, the guy who wore them. But Gammy's parents didn't come to pick them up. So then guess who was knocking at my door this morning?
Aiden.
Yeah, the kid who gave them to Gammy. And I'm like, I got a little paper to sell them. This is not on me anymore. And then, so then I said, go back and talk to the secretary, because Ms. Nunez knows where she stuck those things.
Mahira.
And
not Mahira.
If Gammy's parents didn't pick them up, they should still be there. And guess whose parent has to pick them up now? So what's the point of this? What is the point of this?
Don't wear earpods!
Don't wear your earpods. You shouldn't even be bringing them if they're that cool and expensive. And don't lend them to a kid that's going to wear them. And don't put your freaking hood on your head.
Stop wearing AirPods, Mick. Me? Yeah. Yeah, stop wearing AirPods.
Yeah, see?
Nope.
So, yeah, so that was like a big, like, so I already wrote a referral. And that was Luna. I go and tell her, yeah, the kids look too. I'm like, how many freaking emails do I have to write over this one kid that got caught with stupid AirPods? Can you just follow the rules? Because now it's all about me.
Can we,
you
know, take the quiz?
My time is money, people.
Can we?
You just want the money. That's all you want.
15 minutes of my life writing those emails yesterday.
Okay, take the quiz already.
Okay, we're waiting for Charles to clear the desk. And what happened to the kid that sits by Charles?
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. You're
it's Nick, I told you.
He's not even in his chair. Yeah, it's like all my fault. There really isn't a clear path with clear desks on any of the rooms.
God.
Like, I could go to Ben, and then I could go all the way to Jada, but then when I get to Kelsey,
I'm gonna have my phone right
there's the books. If I start here, Kelsey's I got these two girls, and there's Mick. Where are your desks?
Don't talk to strangers.
Wait, did we not announce you to clear your desk except for the blue model paper?
Wait, how is it only my stuff? Because Angelica's not here. Yeah. That's not true. This is the pang.
Have you ever kind of noticed?
Can you stop?
I'm like, kind of get like really overly mad. Over stupid issues that waste my time.
She took my chapstick. Fingers, boo boo boo, you
win. I would be done with work so much earlier in the day. See how nice it would be if we just all followed the rules? Everyone would be happy. But no, it just takes one complicated, convoluted kid to get in trouble.
Thank you.
And then I get all bent out of shape.
Ms. Rocky sends an email every day about homework.
Why?
And then she complains about it. Like, I don't know.
Who?
See? It's terrible to care because then you never get done with your job.
Yeah. Okay.
So in the future, I should just be one of those teachers that just, What really pissed me off was when I sent 3 emails at 3 different periods of the year about the same stupid thing. And then I found out that that kid's parent wasn't even receiving the emails because it wasn't their right email.
You can't be hitting the student.
Do not touch her like that.
Oh, you're supposed to be moving this away. I touched you in the paper. Imagine my annoyance when I wrote all those emails and I was like, man, that parent sucks. They don't even reply to my email. Like, and then they weren't even getting the email. But like, hey, I wasn't the one that put the wrong email address in the computer of the school form when I signed my kid up. You know what I mean? It's like, get your data straight, people. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Oh, God.
It wasn't until Miss Nunez tried to email that parent that then Miss Sandra talked to the parent and then they found out it wasn't the right email. And I was like, thanks. Okay. See, none of you understand this because none of you ever have to get emails about problem issues because, you know. Yes, because your class is the Angelica class.
The Angelica class?
Except what? For you. Just kidding. What? I was just kidding. That's kind of mean. Yeah, the spiral light. I might have emailed about the spiral. But why? I'm such a complainer. You're always complaining with things.
No, I'm just going to keep
it. No, I'm going to read a bunch of. Write the letter. Oh my God, how short could it be? You drew a big, huge, long line when you could have just wrote a letter. Oh, but I showed you on the screen. Didn't I show you on the screen?
Yeah.
Wasn't that me down there? Yeah, that was the right answer. Where did the answer go, though? Oh,
I don't know any of this. Oh, my God.
That letter was there.
Wait, she gave you this answer?
Yeah, I gave you an answer. I was trying to show you how to use the letters, please, because I don't want you to draw lines that crisscross all over the place, and I don't want you to write words that I can't tell where they're really pointing to. Everybody get it? Yeah. So, this is that. No, not until the test is over. Just leave it on your table. Yeah.
Ariana.
See, doesn't follow directions. Just put the letter from now on. I'm so sure.
Oh my God, I don't know any of this. I'm gonna go to the packet.
Alright, period 3. Somebody's gonna get their test to delay because they're making too much extra noise. And then you will have a bad score.
I have my test. Ariana, lower it down. Ariana. Lower it down. Come on. This doesn't help. Right there. Ariana, I need help. I don't know any of this. I know. Let me see. Why didn't you see that? Oh, I thought. It smells bomb. Explain how the process of C4 spreading hits the rock. We're just gonna make something up. Hopefully it's good enough.
But I'm counting on Sophia and Ben, who is not in his seat, to pet Ben to pass the basket. I want the blue thing in the basket and the test in my hand. As soon as I get your test, I go to Hawaii a lot. Yeah, Oahu's a good one, right? Because it's totally touristy. It's the one that has the really big hotels and the really fancy beach.
Waikiki.
Yeah. A lot of movies are filmed on the Waikiki. Right now, a lot of people go to Maui because
it has
you can drive around the whole island like in a day.
So I don't like going there.
But it has a pretty good section of it where it's like kind of tourist.
Okay, so we're going to fourth period. It's raining. Not okay. Go. So I just seen Eric talking to what's her face, Jasmine. Not okay, because he's digging my room.
Sorry, I need to pull down my jacket.
So covers my.
Are you scared?
Ass. Yeah, for what? Yes, I am.
Are you keeping my phone?
Yeah. Then I'll give it back to Ariana.
What's this, David D? David Dobrik. Oh my God. Ew.
Wait, what?
It's just on the floor. So David D.
Oh, David D. David Dobrik.
What are the chances of payment into our school?
It's so fucking cold. Ceiling once again. Wait. Oh my God. There's so many puppies.
Ben, stop flashing.
What?
Here are some bloopers for you about Brianna.
It's the stigma. The ridge push
is the one where gravity pulls the dude from the crust downward. And that's the one that happens at the mid-ocean ridge. And then, the ocean
is going to change it to you don't have me anything that special.
Crust
you have no
of the
me, so
sea that's denser than the crust that contains continent land. Did you hear that? Yeah, the denser thing sinks. So it's not thicker, it's thinner, but it's heavier, so it's denser. So the denser one sinks underneath the less dense one. Everybody get it got good?
Yeah.
Okay, and then the last is the boundary of transform.
This is my bag.
It's the kind that often makes earthquakes. And then the new island form. So then you got like the big island, and you got
this is the final result.
Kauai, Maui, Big Island of Hawaii.
This is the end of the video. Make sure you like and subscribe and comment what you'd like to see next.